We will send them off. It's when the last part of the aircraft clears the ground is the distance on the short field takeoff. On the short field landing, as they approach, they're approaching for the same line identified by the flags in the line. On that, it's when the mains touch the ground. Each one of the cones that you see is every 20 feet. The smaller markers are every 10 feet to kind of help you keep track of where you are. A little background on the aircraft that they're flying today. You'll notice that all the aircraft park in the grassy area are tail draggers, what's commonly referred to, which is different than those aircraft that you're commonly used to seeing at a commercial airport. We'll talk about that more in a minute. Also, for safety reasons, there is a white line that separates the spectator area from the viewing area. We'd ask everybody stay back from that white line. Also, throughout the evening and through the pig roast, you are welcome to look at any of the aircraft that we have on display, as well as the ones that are being used for the event. We would ask that you not touch the aircraft unless you've been given permission by the pilot. And please, as always, no smoking on the aircraft grounds. All these aircraft are fully fueled as they sit. A little background on the tailwheel portion of the aircraft. The tail draggers, as they're commonly referred to, and you'll notice the one taxiing right in front of us now, you'll notice that they sit high up in the nose and back on the tail. When these aircraft were originally introduced into service, they were used for off-airport operations, and the tail dragger allowed the engine and the prop to be higher off the ground to stay away from prop strikes. The larger tires allow these aircraft to not only land on rugged terrain, but to take off and land in very short distances. The pilots that are here today come from all over the country, and in fact, fly in different flyouts all throughout the country. Our trip to New Holstein is often referred to as our reunion when we all come together once a year from those different locations. We need a couple more spotters from the Super Cub group. You've got to be able to run just a little bit. We're going to send you through a physical fitness test. If you're picked by the judge, you'll be asked to be doing 20 push-ups, and it'll be followed by sit-ups.
Hotel, Flight of Passage Cup.
out there. They keep swapping their clipboards around.
Planes align this year.
This ain't a song for the broken hearted. A silent prayer for faith departed.
First pilot up is Wendy Lessig. This will be the short field takeoff. Remember the object here, she'll drop to the line. The shooter will give her the word to go. Once she goes, it's the last part of the aircraft to leave the ground. The spotters will identify what that part is. The judge will make the final determination. We're back to the scorekeepers for a distance. Feet for Wendy Lessig. Rick Papp is our next pilot. He's ready to go. The shooter gives the signal and Rick Papp is on.
Two fifty-two
for Rick Papp. Our next pilot. This is Rick Lessig. For Jeff Lessig. Notice that when the pilots take off, the first thing they do is lower the nose, lifting the tail into the air. And the Phelps now lead at 141 feet. Next up is Tim Fremantle.
Two hundred seventy feet
for Tim Allen. That concludes the first round of our takeoffs as the pilots circle around for their landings. This aircraft leaving right now is not part of the competition. He heard there's a buffet special over in Oshkosh and he's on his way.
my part.
Lewis, you ready?
Okay, get ready.
What is this, short landing?
Yeah.
Landing, yes, ma'am.
You're gonna catch a lot of
behind the line, but white line there, please.
Our first pilot on the approach is Wendy Lessing. Her takeoff distance was 300 feet.
But he's got a fuzzy mic.
Keep in mind, as the pilots approach, they're looking at the windsock at the end of the field and taking into consideration the headwind, crosswind component as they come in and make their approach.
Can you hear that thing?
Barely. The plane has to come to a complete stop.
We only got so much
runway. Landing distance for Wendy is 348 feet. To put it into perspective, anything over 300 feet is probably not going to win today's contest, and you'll notice that the cones don't go out much over. Do not go much over 300 feet. The commercial aircraft you're used to flying at the airport often take off in an excess of 5,000 feet. Our next pilot on the approach is Rick Papp. For Rick Papp. This is Jeff Russell on the approach. We had a correction in on Wendy Lessig's distance at 338 for Wendy. DeAndre Falls, our current takeoff champion, is on his approach. Disqualification on DeAndre Falls.
Actually, they can touch the back wheel before the line.
They can?
Yeah.
It's the front.
Our next pilot coming in is Tim Allen. You might remember him from Tim the Tool Man Taylor on Tool Time. Just to be clear, it's not the same guy, sorry. Second takeoff attempt, her first attempt.
60 feet for Wendy. Up next is Rick Papp. Feet for Rick Papp. Up next, Jeff Russell. Feet for Jeff Russell. And the Falk is up next. Feet for Dan DeFault. Feet for Tim Allen. If you look to your left, Wendy is on her second approach. Feet for Wendy Lessig. Up next on the approach to your left, Rick Papp. Next, Jeff Russell. Feet for Jeff Russell and the fall on his second approach. 291 feet. Tim Allen will be our final for this round. Feet for Tim Allen. Pilot that just took off is Harry. I want to be a pilot, a bush pilot, as I was listed at 298 feet. Up next is Chris Newsom.
His takeoff ended in the next county.
While we're waiting for the next aircraft to come in, up next is going to be the flower drop. If somebody wants to volunteer to be a bombardier, come over to the announcer's table over here. We actually allow kids to do this too. You don't have to have any special talents other than you don't puke on the pilot. If you feel like you had a big lunch, you probably shouldn't do it.
Here comes one.
money they need. Every morning, yeah. I want to have my sleep for them. I'm signed up.
On the approach is Harry, I want to be a bush pilot. We looked at his driver's license, and that is, in fact, what it says. Okay, we're going to switch the order. Chris Neeson was on the approach. He got waved off because we still had an aircraft on the runway. Our next aircraft on the approach may choose and has the option to go around. The comment, if you look to the left, you'll see the aircraft coming in and what's commonly referred to as a slip. It's a great way to lose altitude in a short amount of distance without giving up tremendous amounts of airspeed. And look at the altitude loss to make up for. Instead of making a rapid descent and having to increase your airspeed and still be able to make a beautiful landing. Darren Luck, and after all that, his luck ran out. I've been informed his name is actually Darren Lucky on occasion. This next pilot is Ryan Johnson.
Dog on the runway.
Chris Neeson is back on his approach. The last landing was 308 feet. He's good. You do lose points by hitting a spotter, just so you know. While we have a few seconds while the Septabria comes back around, we're still looking for a few flower bombs. Not flower bombs. We'll put one more name on the list. 340 for the last landing.
Oh, I got him.
Oh, you're going to use that as an excuse.
At the end of the first round, the takeoff leader was Dan DeFault at 113 feet, and the landing distance was Tim Allen at 260 feet. Those are your leaders. Jake Robinson on the last approach did have the option to go around. He took it. He is on his final approach now.
Yeah.
Another slip. Into the takeoff series, it's Harry, I Want to Be a Bush Pilot. Harry, I Want to Be a Bush Pilot. This is Jared Lucky. For Chris Neeson. Up next in the Satabi of Jake Robinson. Checking in at 282 feet, he's well on his way. This is Darren Lucky, second attempt. Up next, Ryan Johnson. Ryan Johnson's disqualified. If you like the music, it's Lou Furlong, our judge's theme music. Chris Thiessen on his second approach.
Do it, buddy.
feet for Chris Neeson. That is your new leader. Or is it? Chris Neeson is now your new unofficial leader. We'll double check and make it official here in a minute. But Lou's theme song has to end before we can confirm it. Jake Robinson on his second approach.
Next
background on Bill Rusk. Bill Rusk is actually flying shooter Randy Corcoran's airplane because Randy couldn't take part in the event because he is doing the competition. 303 feet for Bill Rusk. Bill Rusk is also a Southwest Airlines captain, so you have that to look forward to on your next trip. Guys, to notice that Rick Papp is handing out water to all the judges and spotters. That's called bribery, and it works. On the approach, Mike Ramos. Mike Ramos stopped just short of Fond du Lac. Jim Stevenson's on the approach in the 170. While we wait for this next aircraft to come in, some people might ask, why is it important to be able to land in short distances like this? Earlier today, a lot of the pilots from Super Cub flew over to a private farm not too far from here. It's actually a working farm, but the landing distance maximum at that location was 1,000 feet. There was no room for go-around, so it was very important that the pilots there had the skills and the abilities to land to stop the aircraft in 1,000 feet. Although they are doing it for competition today, the short field technique is one that you actually learn when you get your private pilot's license. Short and soft field landings are a requirement. On the approach, Steve Pierce, in the only tricycle gear aircraft in the competition. Pierce took a left turn at Albuquerque, and he'll come back around.
It kind of sounds like you, Steve.
Can your dad be better enough?
I bet he
didn't have the pressure on the brakes.
Doyle! 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 All right, ladies and gentlemen, on the approach, your award-winning Ed Doyle. Gets to go again. On the approach, Captain Bill Rusk. to go again too. All right, here we go, round two. Up first, Mike Ramos. Excellent for a tricycle gear airplane. Ladies and gentlemen, up next, Ed Doyle. Let's hear it for Ed. Even the Scottish have to move up for Ed. Bill Russ, flying shooter's plane. Feet for Captain Bill Rusk. At the end of the second round, our official results that we have in, and these will change as the third round comes in. Our takeoff leader is Dan Default at 113 feet. Our landing leader is Chris Nissan, at 162 feet. Thank you. 6 feet for Ed Doyle. On the approach, Bill Russ. First is Joe McDonald in the Huskies. Tracy. Ford. Still leads at 113 feet takeoff. Chris Neeson still leads 162 feet for landing distance. In the third round, your third round leader was Ed Doyle. 156 takeoff, 186 landing. On the approach, Joe McDonough. Tracy. Feet for Bill Tracy. On the approach from the left, Terry Duff.
Joe McDonough.
up next, Bill Tracy. Joe McDonough.
I get that a lot.
Next, Bill Tracy from the left. Seat for Bill Tracy as we get this next plane coming in. If you're a bombardier in the flower top, which is coming up next, please wait for your pilot to come across the line and come get you, and then we'll escort everybody across. If you're one of the people who signed up, we will call you by name based on how many we need. This is Terry Dow. Yeah. 295 feet. Now we start our last round of takeoffs and landing. In the carbon cup, Calvin Brandt. Judge Lou Furlong had asked us to play this song again because he's feeling homesick. Reminder, if you're a bomber for the flower bomb competition, wait till the pilots come and get you. If you're one of the ones that signed up, we'll call your name. First on the approach is the Carbon Cub, flown by Calvin Brandt. Thank you. judges are going to say he DQ'd. He has asked for an instant replay and has been denied. There was not compelling evidence that he did not touch the ground, therefore the call will not be overturned. How do you approach Lynn Gardner from the left?
That rope and that zip and you still need to.
Feet for Lynn Gardner. Up again on the line, the Carvin Cub, won by Calvin Brea. Trying to obscure his takeoff location.
Here's the voice
of
the smoke.
203 with the smoke on the Carvin Cub. Up on the line, Greg Daughtry. This is Lynn Gardner on her second and last takeoff. Tracy at 287 feet. Our overall competition leaders, Dan Dufault at 113 feet still leads in the takeoff. Chris Neeson still leads at 162 feet in the landing. Alan Brett and the Carvin Cub. Notice the smoke is not on. It may have helped. On the approach from the left, Greg Daughtry. Feet. On the approach is Lynn Gardner. Okay, folks, that wraps up the takeoff and landing short field competition. How about a nice round of applause for the pilots who took part? Also, a nice ovation for our shooter, who will be back in just a minute. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Randy Korfman. Yay,
Randy!
All right, it's going to take us just a few minutes to reset the course for the bomb drop. The pilots will come get their bombardiers. We do have a couple more planes we're going to add. We have to reposition the course. Give us just a few minutes to do that, and we'll start the flower bomb drop. For those of you who have never seen it before, it is a spectacle, and there is a good chance you'll be wearing flower before you leave. Your unofficial winners of the competition in 2014, Dan DeFault with 113 feet takeoff distance. Chris Neeson was your